It is very easy to make tools in Godot, and by using the new particle seek command, you can make yourself a really cool particle system debug tool. It allows you to scroll your particles in time and see exactly what they are doing. So follow along as we learn how to use it and how tools work in Godot. Here I have my explosion particle. So to start, let's stop this particle from running and create a new script called particle debug. The first thing we need to do is to add the add tool decorator at the top. This will tell Godot it is a tool script and allow it to run inside the editor. Next, we are going to add the add export variable to control our particle time called seekPos, and we are going to declare a setter for it by putting a colon at the end and declaring a set value function. Now, every time we change the seekPos, this will be called instead, and we can do things here. So first, let's set our seekPos with the value that was passed. Assigning the seekPos variable here won't trigger the setter. And now we can call the new particle function, requestParticleProcess. This will execute the particle processing for some time. So let's put our particle seek here and see what happens. Well, nothing is happening. No change at all. And that's because we need to reopen our scene to make our tool script work properly. You can also go to Scene, Reload Saved Scene. And now the script has turned blue, meaning it is running inside the editor. So when we try to change the seekPos now, something happens. Each time we change this value, we advance the particle in time by that amount. But that is not very useful for us, so let's fix that. Back to our script, let's change the particle time to 0 with speed scale equals 0. Then call restart and pass true to keep the random seed. By doing that, each time we change the seekPos value, we are actually resetting the particle and baking the particle process until it hits that point in time again. And because the seed is the same, it looks like we are scrolling in time. But we still have a couple more things to fix. To fix these jitters, you need to disable the interpolate inside the particle system. This is used to make the particle move at a higher FPS than they really are, by interpolating their positions. But this can cause serious problems if the time scale is set to 0. So no more jitters for now. Now, you might have noticed that our particles are still moving. And that's our shader. It animates our mesh by using the engine or game time, and the particle speed scale doesn't seem to affect this. You might be okay with this. But let's see how we can also pause this in time while we adjust a few more things. Going back to our code, let's make sure that we don't animate the particles backwards in time. And also disable it. And set the engine.timescale to 0. And nothing happens. We actually can't set the timescale to 0, or else the particle restart won't even try to be called, so we can use a really small value instead. And there we go. Our particle is stopped in time. But because we changed the engine time, a lot of things broke. We can't even zoom anymore, because zoom uses the engine time to smoothly zoom the camera out. So let's quickly go back, turn our time scale to 1, and change seekPos to any value, just so this code is called. Now we can zoom back again, and time is restored. So, to deal with this, we are going to create a button to reset the time. Let's change our time back to 0, and create a new function, resetEngineSpeed, that just set the time scale back to 1. Next, we are going to use the new addExportTo button, passing the button name and the icon it will use, and finally declare our button variable, which points to a callback to the real function. And now we have a button. Let's try put a print inside to see if it's really working. And it didn't work. That is the thing with two scripts. Some modifications will need to reload the script for it to work, and create a new button is one of them. So, let's reload our scene again. And now our button works. We can scroll the particles, and when we want, we can click the button to change the engine time back to normal. Before Godot 4.4, the easy way to create buttons was to use a bool variable, and use its setter, execute code. And now, just a few minor changes. I forgot to add return when we seek a negative value, and if we try to scroll the particle to 0, it stops at the first frame when the particle is already created. So let's also add a restart to clean the particles, and set the engine time back to 1, just to be sure. Now, if we scroll it back, it will disable the particle and make it look all nice. And finally, a tip when working with two scripts. If you break something really bad to the point that Godot won't even start anymore, you can always open the script outside of Godot and just comment out the code. This will allow Godot to restart normally. This usually happens when you put an infinite loop inside your tool script that is running in the Godot thread. But that's it. A really cool usage of the new request particle process in Godot 4.4. That lets you take a very close look on how your particles really work. If you want, you can get the project files of these tutorials by supporting me on Patreon. I hope you liked this video, and until next time.